It's a fucking snow day. It is a snow day, funnily enough, is what I'm saying. So I've had the day off because it's out. Sorry, that might have destroyed your eardrum. It probably didn't destroy your eardrum. Pretty good at speaking, you know. It's one of my talents is speaking. Pretty good for a podcast. It's a snow day today, and I've had like things to do, like assignments and stuff for school and stuff. And I have done work, but like it's so boring. It is so boring, and it's hard because it's boring, and I don't want to do it. But you know, I have done some work, but it's just boring, honestly. It's making me think that maybe I should, you know, really get my foot out my arse with this whole YouTube thing, because, you know, if I'm going to end up having to do work for the rest of my life, it's difficult and it's boring, and, you know, YouTube's just fun. It's much more fun. It's much easier. Okay, that's maybe taking it a bit far. YouTube isn't easy, but you know what I mean. It's like, I just can't be bothered working. Not the right outlook on life at all. They're not very wise words by me. Work hard, kids, and stay in school, and, you know, get into good habits when you're young. Get into the good habits of doing homework and working hard in school, because it makes life a lot easier when the work actually starts to matter, like where I am. This is the podcast. As you can tell, the lighting isn't the same as it, you know, the same quality as it usually is. If you're new to the channel, which I feel like a few of you watching this video probably are, you may be like, what the fuck is this video? This doesn't look like very good. Why is the quality so shit and all that stuff? Basically, if you're new to this podcast, because I haven't done a podcast in freaking ages, so a lot of you will probably be new, plus all the subscribers from Matt / PickPixels channel. Basically, the podcast is a thing where, basically, it just gives me an excuse to chat shite at you for an hour or so, however long I decide to do this. Basically, it's just a guy and a camera, and I just talk to you for a while. We just have a bit of a chat. It's not much of a chat. It's more like me speaking to myself and just talking about what's going on in my life, what's going on in the world, just stuff I want to get off my chest, stuff I want to talk about on video and talk to you guys about. And basically, it's just for you to watch / listen to. This isn't the kind of video where you sit down and just look at my face the whole time. Like, I do that with some podcasts sometimes, but like, if chances are you might get bored doing that. So like, if you want to like stick it on in the background when you're doing homework, or if you're, you know, playing games or something, just stick it in the background of something you're doing. If you can like get a downloading app on your phone, download it and download the video or whatever, and just listen to it while you're, I don't know, on the bus, at work, at the gym, on whatever you do in your life, I don't know. And yeah, so basically this isn't the thing where you just sit and watch my face the whole time. You can if you want, but it's kind of up to you what you do with it. And basically, this is a type of video, if you're not familiar with podcasts, basically it's just, you know, very simple, just a guy and a camera. I'm just going to talk with you for a while. Some people like these things, some people don't. A lot of people really enjoy the podcast. I used to do them a lot, like months and months ago now. I got really into them for a while, but I know I got a bit inconsistent for a while. I just felt like I didn't have much to talk about for a few months, but now I felt like a good time to do it. I haven't uploaded in a few weeks as it is now, which sucks, and I'll talk about that in a minute probably. But yeah, it just felt fitting. I've got some other things to talk about, and I don't know, I just want to have a bit of a chat with you. I want to get back into doing podcasts a bit more regularly, maybe not like once a week, you know, because I just don't have that many. My life isn't interesting enough to do a podcast every single week. I'm thinking of getting guests on. I'm thinking of getting some guests on. Did the camera always look this bad before I had the fancy lights? Because it looks terrible now, really, compared. So yeah, sorry about the lighting, but if I have the big fancy light on, it's not really good to have it on for like an hour plus straight. Like, for doing a podcast, it's a bit more chill. I don't need to be all professional. It's just, like I said, you're just supposed to listen to it. The video quality doesn't matter. As long as the audio is fine, then it's, you know, that's what the podcast is about. It's just a chat. It's nothing formal. So if I had the big light on, one, I'd be sweating, the room would be very hot, but also the light, it's not good for being on for more than like 20 minutes or something. It starts to like flip out a bit. So it's, you know, flashed and made some weird noises and started to like it hasn't melted yet, but I'm kind of worried that it will like catch fire in the middle of a podcast. So the light isn't in. It's just very chill, very informal. And yeah, like I said, I'm just me having a chat with you, and you know, you can leave your thoughts in the comments about anything I talk about. And yeah, it's just a bit of a chat session, a bit of one-on-one stuff within all my other edited entertainment, if you want to call it entertainment. So I was talking about something else before that, but it doesn't matter. So I feel like the first topic that I should talk about is where I've been. And well, you can probably guess, to be honest. Talk about prelims as well, Christ. Okay, we'll talk about that in a minute. Right, so, and also in this podcast, because it's very informal and it's just like completely uncut, there's like no cuts, nothing, it's just very raw. There'll be a few pauses where I'm trying to like think of, gather up my thoughts, what I'm trying to say, catch my breath every now and then, because talking for an hour straight just, it's not good for you. You need to catch your breath every now and then, and I'll be taking drinks and all this stuff, so. I hope the audio's okay. I haven't really checked the microphone. So hopefully it's all good. So basically, where I've been, it's been my inconsistency has hit not an all time high, but it's not been good. It's not been very good. And basically, there's no real reason for it. It's basically I'm very good at leaving things to the last minute, as a lot of you probably are as well, with school stuff and stuff like that. And I have these days where I come home from school, I'm like, okay, I should get on with all this stuff and get either do a video or do some work. But I'm like, okay, the work isn't due for like till the end of the week. I'll just chill out for the night and just have a night to myself as if I haven't had enough of those. When I could be, you know, making a video or something like that, I thought, oh, I've got plenty of time till the work's, it's due for Friday, it's only Tuesday, I've got plenty of time. And then I don't make a video either because I just uploaded yesterday, 2 days ago, I've still got time. And like, I've just got the completely wrong attitude to it sometimes, which sucks, and it's something I want to change about myself, but I'll go on for a minute. And then, you know, it gets to a few days later, it gets to closer to the deadline, I'm like, you know, it's Wednesday or Thursday or something, I'm like, okay, I've really got to get this done now, get the work done, and I'm like, okay, I could record a video and also make the use of my time, but if I record a video, I shouldn't record a video because I should be doing this schoolwork. So, you know, I don't record a video because I'm meant to be doing schoolwork, but then I end up not doing the schoolwork a lot of the time because I just can't be bothered some of the time, and I'm just like really lazy like that. And then you just end up, you know, watching YouTube videos for the entire evening, and you just get into this rut. You just get into this, you know, cycle, which is really hard to break sometimes. And then it ends up you haven't uploaded for a week. You've got like an assignment due for the next day. You've got homework for the next few days, and you're just like, okay, I need to just focus on this work and get it done. And that's basically what's happened. In this whole thing, I've just had work that I haven't gotten to quick enough, and I have had opportunities to work. I'm not gonna sit here and come up with excuses. I'm just a lazy cunt sometimes. That's just the way I am, and it sounds like a defeatist attitude, doesn't it? I'm not like proud of being that way, but it's something about me that's, I don't know. If you're new to this channel, you're new to me. If you're a new subscriber or whatever, you don't know much about me, then it's something about these podcasts. Also, you can learn a bit about me listening to me talk. You'll pick up things about my personality and things about me as we go along, things that I don't even mean to say, but you'll interpret it in different ways. Everyone interprets things different ways. Like when I watch a video, like I pick up things and I think about things in different ways. That's one thing about not just videos, life in general. And I need to take off my socks. It's already getting warm. That's the thing with these podcasts, it gets warm very, very quickly. And I should probably, I'm taking off my socks. I've got two pairs of socks on. And the outside pair of socks is like really woolly thick socks because it's cold, because obviously it's snow. There's enough snow that the buses weren't running. So, you know, it's going to be pretty cold. My cheeks are already going quite red, but hopefully with this lighting, you can't see that. So, basically over the past wee while, my consistency hasn't been good for a while now, but just recently since, was it the Black Ops 3 video? Was last year, I think it was. It's, you know, since that video, it's been even worse than it has been. And like I say, for the reason of that is I get into these cycles, and like it's getting into a cycle, getting into a bad habit. The hardest thing is breaking that habit, but once you break it, it's quite easy to stay out of it. I've noticed this with a few things in my life. If you can break that habit, just like the first step is the hardest in situations like that. And like, I'm not talking about like addiction or anything, like, you know, I've never had like, you know, I can't speak about, you know, alcohol problems or smoking or drugs or whatever else. You know, I can't really say anything on that because I don't have experience with that. But just in things I've experienced with my life, a lot of this podcast is just me talking about my experiences in life, because obviously I'm quite a young person. I've had, you know, I'm still in school. I haven't experienced a lot of things in life. But just with the things I have experienced, I don't know, I can maybe relate to you in some ways, and you can take what I say and use it in your own life. I don't know. I'm not pretending to be, you know, some wise freaking guru of information or anything. But, you know, everyone, like I said, everyone interprets things different ways, and, you know, I've used a lot of things from YouTube videos, things people have said that which didn't, you know, weren't meant to teach me something, but they did, you know, that sort of stuff. But, yeah, so basically, what am I trying to say? Basically, I'm really lazy, is what I'm trying to say. I'm a lazy fucking shit person sometimes, and, yeah. I could take this opportunity to say, oh, I'm back, and the consistency will be back. But I've said this quite a few times in doing YouTube over the last few years, and I can't guarantee anything, to be honest. Like, I don't know, the thing, I quite like just having fun on YouTube. I don't like taking it too seriously, but when it gets to the point where you're not uploading for like a week or 2 weeks, I like to have a minimum one video a week, which is kind of what I've been doing for a while now, and I've kind of fallen out of that recently as well. But my aim ultimately is to just get, my, in best case scenario, the videos I make, I'd love to get like two or three videos every week, three videos a week probably. Two would be like okay, I'd be okay if I was getting two videos out a week. One, like, bare minimum. That's like my whole thing, because the videos I make, I know everyone says, oh, upload daily, that's the best way to grow, upload daily. But with the videos I make, like, it's not, it's less a thing of laziness, it's more of a thing of it probably is possible, but with, for most people, it's not. Like, you have to have a very certain, like, mindset, which, not, you know, I'm obviously very a lazy person, very procrastinating person, but like, for even like most people, a lot of other YouTubers, the level of work I put into every single video, not that it's like hard and strenuous, just that it takes a lot of time, my videos, like the edited ones specifically, to like make every single one. I have to spend genuinely a lot of hours, not even like in the editing, just like letting things load, because my computer isn't the best, my software isn't great, so it's, you know, it freezes and, you know, it lags and I have to reset the whole thing. And then even the editing, it takes, you know, I can spend, like, not a couple of days straight, but I can spend just a couple of days, you know, in tandem with school or, like, work or whatever else I'm doing, on one video, which, you know, it's not a case of, like, I can just record, edit, and then upload and have a video ready for tomorrow in, like, one day. Like, I can't come home from school and just make a video. Other, if it's, like, a podcast, then I can, but if it's a normal edited video, then it's just not possible, genuinely, by the, you know, with the amount of time I spend on editing and making, you know, thumbnails and all that stuff. Thumbnails don't take that long, but just the editing phase genuinely takes a lot longer than people might think, which, you know, these are the videos I like to make. It's not an excuse, you know. If I wanted to upload daily, then I could just, you know, make a lot less edited, but I feel like I like making them really edited. I enjoy the editing part, even though it takes a long time and it can be fucking stressful and annoying sometimes. Like, I just have to, sometimes, like, when I'm doing it, I'm going out for hours, then if I take a break for, like, 10 minutes and then I come back to it and I'm like, okay, I found some new inspiration, I found out how I can make this a bit good. It's, yeah, so, I don't know, my videos take a lot of time to edit, and not saying that they're, like, brilliantly edited. They are, you know, I'm quite proud of my videos, but I'm not saying they're the greatest thing ever, you know. But I do spend a lot of time on them, and to upload daily is just, like, not an option. At least not now, in tandem with, you know, everything else I've got going on. So, like I say, two or three videos a week is what I'd like to be doing, ideally. Maybe doing, like, podcasts as well. Or, you know, other videos. I want to try and do some other videos, but I don't know. It's just, I always have these things, oh, I want to do, like, I don't know, like, vlogs or, like that Shit Happens video. I want to do funny little, so not skits, but stuff like that. But, I don't know, it just feels like, it never feels like I have time. Even though I do have time, I just, in my head, I just feel like I don't have the freedom to have time. I don't know, I feel like there just isn't enough hours in the day sometimes, even though there is. And if I, like, didn't waste so much of that time, I would. But, I don't know, it's just, I don't know. Like I say, cycles. You get into cycles of thinking, you get into ruts, and it's hard to break that cycle, and it can be kind of scary sometimes, and then the stress gets on you, and then you haven't done all your schoolwork, and shit, I've got an assignment due for tomorrow, which ironically I do. You know, that assignment that I was talking about earlier, which I have worked on, but like I say, it's boring, man. And I've done a lot of this. I've got my arm leaning on the desk here, which is kind of what I do. It just, you know, supports me. I don't like having to sit up straight the whole time. I just sort of, you know, chill. So that's where I've been for the past few weeks, basically. Like I say, it's sort of the same old story. I'm a bit late, I'm lazy, I let things pile on top of me, and then the stress gets to me, and then procrastination continues, and then more stress, and then it's all a cycle. And hopefully with this podcast, I've sort of broken the cycle a little bit, and I can upload more videos and all that. But like I say, it's a weird thing. A lot of YouTubers say, like, oh, I'm sorry I haven't uploaded, and a lot of people, you know, YouTubers like, I don't know, like Matt or something, you know, he uploads every single day, or, you know, Matt's a big YouTuber compared to me, but, you know, like, big YouTuber with millions of subs, if they don't, you know, like the Sidemen who upload, like, every single day, if they didn't upload, you know, if they missed a day of uploading, they'd have to, like, you know, apologize and say, I'm sorry there wasn't a video, you know, it couldn't be helped or anything like that, and, like, you know, because people genuinely care about, I've spoken about this before with Max, and I think, like, the podcast we did, like, 9 months ago or something on his channel. People with those channels, like, I feel like they really care about those channels, and in a way that, like, it's part of their daily routine. They expect a video to come out every single day, and they really look forward to every single day, and if it doesn't come out, then they can be quite, you know, disappointed. Whereas with my channel, I know people care about my channel, and there's, I've got some freaking sick people who watch these, just, you know, people watching videos I make anyway is amazing, but I've got some really sick people watching these videos, and, you know, but even though, like, if I don't upload for a while, I feel like people will care, but it's not like they'll kick off about it, which, I don't know, maybe gives me a false sense of security, but, like, I mean, people, you know, people will unsubscribe, and people will, like, so I'll gain, that's how you gain active subs, is by being inconsistent like that, and I'm fully aware of that. But I don't know, it's just, it's a thing that I don't feel like I need to come out and say, oh, I'm sorry I haven't uploaded, and I don't feel I need to, like, apologize and be all like this, because, one, it happens a lot, so I don't want to just be constantly apologizing, but also the fact that, like, I feel like, you know, people, most of you aren't sitting there, you know, on my channel every day, like, oh, Drew uploaded a video. Maybe some of you are. You might check every now and then and be like, oh, Drew hasn't been uploading much, but it's not like you know, you care that much about me and, like, my channel, because apparently there are people who do enjoy my videos, which I don't like saying, because I don't want to feel like I'm sucking my own dick, because it's just weird that anyone does seem to like watching these videos, but, you know, it's kind of a weird thing. I don't feel like I want to have to come out all the time and apologize, just because I don't feel like people mind that much. Obviously, people want to see me uploading, and want to, you know, there are people who want to see me grow and want to help me with that, but I don't feel like, you know, people, I don't feel like I'm disappointing loads of people if I don't upload, which, I don't know, whether or not that's a good thing or a bad thing. I don't want to make it sound like a bad thing. It just, I'm trying to, you know, bring myself down to earth, basically, and say, you know, I'm not that important. It's not that important if I don't upload, just because these videos, I just do YouTube, like, for fun. Ultimately, I do want to grow, and I do want to do it, you know, I do want to do YouTube full time, but it's like, I don't know. It's a weird thing, but yeah. I don't know if you understood what I said there. Basically, if you don't, like, understand anything I say, then it's fine. Like, if you want to, like, ask questions, like, what did you actually mean when you said this? Because when I'm talking, like, it's gone out of focus. What's happened? There you go. Like, sometimes when I'm speaking, I feel like I don't make sense, but I feel like, you know, people, like I say, people interpret things their own way, and even if I don't make sense, people will ultimately probably interpret it in some way and, you know, make sense of it in their own head somehow. But I don't know, if you got anything, any, you know, questions, if you don't get what I'm really saying, or if you have opinions, or you're like, is this what you're thinking, then, you know, leave everything in the comments, because I love comments. Everyone loves comments. Everyone who does YouTube loves comments. It's just a great thing. Anyway, so that's basically, I don't know, that's basically where I've been. It's sort of the same old, and, you know, I'm always looking to improve myself. It's really difficult. It's, I don't know, the mind, it sounds, you know, it's classic easier said than done type thing, even though it sounds easy to just, you know, make a video and keep doing regular videos, it's not so much hard work as in, like, physically, I don't know, it's like a mental drain. Some being creative person, it's you know, not like hard work as like working on a build. I heard this on the True Jordy podcast a while ago, doing, like, creative things, like doing YouTube videos, or I don't know, doing, like, music or something like that, or, you know, being an actor, I don't know, being a writer, that sort of stuff, it's not like hard work as in, like, hard physical work, you know, it doesn't actually tire you out, like, you know, being a builder on a building, you know, construction worker, that, you know, that all that's, you know, physical work, that sort of stuff, it's not that sort of tiring, not that sort of physically draining, it's more mentally draining. It's kind of a weird thing where, like, it mentally drains you in some way, and it's like, it's, I'm not gonna say it's harder, because obviously I've never, you know, done, like, hard physical work, you know, for, like, years and years like that. I've never, you know, I haven't had that sort of life, I haven't had that sort of experience. I'm not gonna say it's harder being a creative person, but it's a different kind of exhaustion and draining and tiredness when you're doing something creative. It's a weird, I don't know, it's a weird thing. If you are a YouTuber or something like that, or you do stuff like that, then you'll know what I mean, probably. I feel like you'll probably know what I mean, but it's, I don't know, there's something, it's all mental, it's a lot of mental stuff, and it's harder to deal with than it sounds. Like, you're just like, oh, dude, it's just your mind, it's all in your head, it's, you know, it's easy to just make a video, but I don't know, it's just, I don't know, maybe, I feel like I need to be mentally stronger, probably. I feel like mental strength is something that is quite a good, you know, quite an important thing in this day and age, with so many sort of, I don't know, creative industries and stuff like that, a lot more, like, sort of, you know, less physical things, you know, I don't know, mental strength these days is something that's quite important for a lot of aspects of just life in general, It's something like you, it's really useful to have, and it's something that I don't really have. Like I said, I'm quite lazy. I procrastinate quite a lot, but I don't know. You probably know what I mean. If you know what I mean, then you know what I mean. It's that sort of thing. So, this is gonna run out of charge soon enough. I should probably get the charger. So usually I cut this out, but because it's a podcast, we don't need to do any cutting out. Sometimes I do need to do a bit of cutting out just in case I say something that I'm not supposed to. I don't know, I give away my address or something. I've never done that, but you know, sometimes it's necessary. If someone comes into my room to speak to me, I kind of, you know, I want to cut that out, because you don't need to hear my conversations about what I want for tea. You know, that's a bit unnecessary. So, okay, right, that's over with. How long has that been going on for? I don't know. I feel like this might be quite a decently long part. I feel like I probably hit an hour on this one, just because I've got quite a few decent topics to talk about. So, I feel like another thing I should talk about is I should mention it. Should I? Yeah, I probably should. Hang on. Pardon me. Okay. The growth that's happened recently. That when this is what happens when you do a video with a big YouTuber. So obviously I did the video, the two videos, one on my channel, one on his channel, and the growth that when he uploaded that video, holy crap! Like, thinking about it now, it's crazy. Like, a lot of you are, if I don't know, I feel like a lot of his subs who came over, a lot of them who commented on my recent videos, oh, I really like these videos. They probably won't make it all the way into this video because it's different. Not everyone likes the whole podcast thing, which is fine. But I don't know, like, all the people who come over, welcome for one thing. But I don't know, the video went up, and after like, was it like after an hour, I went up like 100 subs, or was it something like that? I'm not sure, it was something like that. Like, you know, in an hour, I'd gone up so many. Like, I saw the video was uploaded, and I was like, oh, sick, that's okay, cool. So, and, you know, I watched the video, I was like, okay, cool, yeah, you know, I don't think we did very well in the games, but that's fine. So yeah, like, he uploaded the video, and I went downstairs, and I was just sort of chilling. I was doing nothing. I expected to gain subs. I don't know why I didn't think, because Matt's freaking big YouTuber now, really. But I didn't think that it would get that much. I would get that much growth, even, you know, just from being on his channel, not from even like doing anything really. I hadn't even uploaded my video with him yet, and then my brother came downstairs. Did he? Yeah, he came downstairs, because I hadn't looked at the live sub count, and he showed me the live sub count. I think, where was that? I was like close to 250 before I made that video with Matt, and then when he uploaded that video, my brother came down, it was like 350 or something like that, and I was like, genuinely, I didn't expect it. I genuinely felt like crying for like 10 seconds. I'm not even lying, I just genuinely couldn't believe it for a second. I don't know why, like, because Matt's like a big YouTuber. I knew I'd grow up, I didn't expect it to be that sudden. And, like, obviously, I'm now at, like, 600. I've gotten past 600. Like, I didn't even know if I'd hit 500 by the end of the year. Like, crikey, all right. Obviously, my consistency. Genuinely, this is something that Oscar said to me and we were chatting on Twitter a while ago. And he said, I think you'll hit 1,000 subs by the end of the year. And I was like, I thought I could do it, but I didn't think my consistency would get me there. But like, we're literally halfway there. We're halfway there. Oh, something, something prayer. Yeah. So that's something I probably should cut out, but I'm not gonna. That was crap. Anyway. So yeah, like if I, dude. It's weird now on YouTube, like, obviously I'm not going to take credit for all of it, that sudden growth. That's all Matt, and all his hard work has just boosted me up, which, you know, I feel kind of bad, but at the same time I don't, because I've just gotten loads of subs. A lot of them are probably going to be inactive, which kind of sucks, but, you know, I'm not going to complain, am I? I have gotten a few more views from it, even though a lot of them, because I haven't uploaded for a while, a lot of them probably switched off now, and probably, you know, I'm going to have even more inactive subs, which is my own fault, you know, no one else to blame for that, which sucks, but, like, it's a weird thing for, like, the first time on YouTube, I genuinely can grow a fair bit. Like, I can get to 1,000 subs, like, before the end, quite easily before the end of the year. I don't want to say quite easily, because, you know, it's not easy because I struggled with consistent videos. But if I uploaded, like, you know, two, maybe three videos, at least two videos every week and three videos a week sometimes, I could genuinely get to 1,000 subs by the end of the year. Even before that, probably. And, like, I've never been able to say that. I've never been able to say before in my life that I can, you know, predict that sort of thing. I can never say, oh, by this point, I could quite easily be at this point if I put the graft in. Like, I've never had that before. Like, I've never had that sort of clear thing, like, I can actually do this. Like, I've said this before, I've said this in the other videos with, you know, years ago on YouTube, I was like, okay, like, you know, I had no subs, I had no one watching the videos. I'd upload, like, 50 videos. I genuinely had no old channel where I uploaded, like, 50, 60 videos just, you know, me playing Minecraft and Call of Duty and other random things. And, like, I didn't even get to, like, did I even get to 20 subs? I don't know if I even got that far. Just because, like, you know, you've got no starting point, you've got no, like, you know, when you're 13, you've got no, like, you know, you and a couple of other mates might do YouTube a bit, and you've got like, no, like, I don't know, jump start. You can't just go straight into it and start gaining subs immediately. Or you can, but you can't, because you can't make good videos when you first start. And it's like, I remember that time so vividly. I remember that, and it's weird to think that I've moved on so much from that, and I've grown so much since then. Not just in terms of numbers, but as, like, a person, as a YouTuber, how different I am now, how much I've learned, and, like, how far I've come since then, when I still feel like I am that, even though I'm not, because I've got 600 subs, and, like, I'm, like, my video's been getting, like, hundreds of views, makes me want to upload consistency. Because if I was uploading, you know, two videos a week, with getting, like, a few hundred views every single video, think of how sick that would look, and I'd be so proud of myself, and I really want to do that. But I don't know, something about my personality, the way I am, I just can't. But I can. I shouldn't have that attitude. I can, but I just know I won't. But I'm gonna, I don't know, I say I know I'm gonna try, but am I? I don't know. I'm making myself sound really bad here, but this is just me being completely honest. Like, I know, you know, judging by past history of what I've, you know, my inconsistency and stuff like that, based on what I've done in the past, I'm not confident that I can change in the future. I'm confident that I can with effort, but I don't know, I just find it hard to put in that effort. I just like procrastinating, man. I don't like it, but I do at the same time. I just like to sit around and do nothing. It's just, I just wish I could do that. Doesn't everyone, but, you know, that's not going to get you anywhere in life, you know. Can't really have that mindset. So yeah, crazy, crazy times on YouTube right now. It'd be interesting to see where we are in a year's time, or by the end of the year, even by summer, like, where I don't know. It's gonna be crazy, crazy year. So, and like I said, I want to do more collabs, like, with Matt and, you know, other people, get people on the podcast and all that stuff. And, yeah, so, what else? So we've done that. Look at my hand. Like, it looks like a skeleton. I've done this a lot. I look a bit sort of, I don't know. What's the word? Camp? That's not the right word. But yeah, also my hair. Sorry about the hair. It's just a bit shit. I don't know. I did have a shower. I got ready to go to school and everything. Like, the bloody school, right? I get up at the same time I always do at 7. I get up and I have my shower and I, you know, I go to all this effort. I wake myself up and I'm like, okay, I'm up. I'm still kind of tired and exhausted after having to, you know, wake up. But, you know, I've had, you know, my breakfast and I'm ready to get going. It's like 5 minutes before I'm about to walk out the door into the snow. There isn't like that much snow, to be honest, but there's a decent amount. Like, I don't know how much there is now, but, you know, I was gonna get wet feet. It was gonna be cold. My mum wasn't gonna drive me anywhere because she didn't want to take the car out in the snow, because, you know, she's not she was like, I'm not taking the car out in that snow. No, I'm not, because, I don't know, my mum can be a bit of a cautious driver sometimes in that when it's icy or snowy. So I had to walk through the snow to the bus to get, and the bus would take me to the other town where the actual school is, and I had to walk across the whole village. My house is, I genuinely think, of the people who have to walk to the bus, because the bus takes us to the other town, so everyone in our little place walks to the bus. All the people, and there's some people who get, like, a mini bus, who live, like, a few miles outside the village, they get, like, a mini bus, and they get taken to the big bus, then the big bus takes them to the big school, that sort of thing. But of all the people who just live in the village and have to walk to the bus, I think I must have the furthest to walk. I genuinely think so, because, like, I'm, like, at the opposite end. It's, like, don't know if they're listening to me. Basically, it's at the opposite end of the place. Like, I'm thinking of like all the people who get on. Like, no one else has a house as far away, because, like, there are some people who live further away from that bit, like, over that way. But they, like, they get, there's another bus stop that they go to, so, like, all the people over here go to that one, all the people over here go to this one. And I'm, like, over here. I'm just, that was a terrible diagram. That was all, like, in the same bit. You didn't understand. Basically, I'm pretty sure I have the furthest to walk, so not good when there's snow and everything like that. And, you know, I'm all woken up. And then, like, 5 minutes before I'm about to walk out the door, they then put on the school website, oh, the buses aren't running, you can stay home, and this, we have to consider the safety of the pupils and the staff. It's like, I could have been out the door walking and trudging through the snow if I, you know, and I might have even gone even earlier, because, you know, it might take me a while to, you know, trudge through the snow and all that. But, no, they just, I mean, it's not that they did it too late, but, like, it's just, like, you know, after I've gotten up and I've woken up and I'm tired because it's still early in the morning and but I've like woken up, so it's not like I can just go straight to bed after having a shower and having eaten. It's not like you can just go straight back into bed. And it's just, wish they could just make their minds up quicker. Ugh. Anyway, where was I going with that? That was just a bit of a rant about the bus company, not the bus company, the school, I guess. When they decide to put the closure news on the website far too late. Right, so. What the hell? What is going on in... Hang on. I've got to check. I shouldn't be checking this in the middle, but like I say, it's... Oh, it's just Max about the snow. I put a picture of the snow in our little group chat that we have, and Max is like, dude, that's mad. We never get snow. Because Max lives on, like, the very south coast of, like, England, and I live up in Scotland, so, you know, they don't get much snow down there. We don't get that much snow up here, but we get more than them, basically. So, yeah. So, another topic, another thing I can talk about. How long? It's half an hour, and I'm just... These podcasts are tiring. It's just exhausting to just speak for the whole time. Okay. Okay, just catch my breath. I'm not, like, out of breath, but I just need a minute to, like, chill. Okay. My nose bleeding. I hope it's not. If you watch my other videos, you will know that when I have a nosebleed, it's not good. I'm like, oh god, I can feel something. I should probably just take a minute to like stop. So okay, we'll just take this minute to chill, everyone. We'll just have a bit of a meditate. I feel like I need to talk because I want to keep entertained, but at the same time, I don't want to start bleeding in front of you. Am I okay? Sorry, just give me a minute. I think I'm good. I can't really be sure. Okay, I'll just take things a bit more chill from now. So, another thing that I'm going to talk about is I got my first ever job. My first ever part-time job. I think I talked about this in another, like one of the podcasts from my ages ago. I've got a whole playlist of podcasts, which you can go listen to if you really want. But basically, in one of those, I talked about, I've never had a part-time, like a weekend job before. And like most of the people I know have, most people my age do already. So like, I was a bit, you know, one of the few people who didn't have a job, and like, you know, my parents like, oh, you should probably, you know, go get a job, you know, probably be a good idea, you know, get some money, get some experience. And, you know, they just want to get me out of the house for, you know, on the weekends, just so I'm not sitting on Mars doing nothing, which, you know, is fair enough, to be honest. So I talked about that in a while on a podcast where I could have been getting a job like months and months ago. I didn't end up getting that job, which I was talking about there. I got another job just working in like a little cafe in the place that I live. Like just basically I just like clean dishes and stuff like that. I clear tables sometimes if they need a few extra people out front. I don't take orders, they don't trust me with that yet. Eventually I'll probably get in, I'll start doing that, but for now I just basically wash dishes and clear tables, sometimes take food out to people and stuff like that. And it's a decent job. I work every Sunday from 12 until 4 o'clock in the afternoon, so not long crazy hours yet. I think that in a few weeks time they'll probably increase that. I might get extra shifts, like, no, someone coming, it doesn't matter. Yeah, I might get extra shifts like on Saturday if someone isn't can't come into work, then I can go in on Saturdays, and I'll get like extra hours as I get more like experience, and if they're happy with the job I'm doing, then they'll give me more hours and my pay will rise in a few weeks, in a few months, everything will get bigger. So I've got a job, it's a decent job, just washing dishes, but And before I go into it, it's a good job, not gonna lie. The people there are very nice, they're very friendly people who work there, and you know, the pay is decent for now. It'll go up, and it'll probably go up eventually a bit, and you know, it's a good job. I'm not complaining, like, I'm quite happy with it. There's nothing really wrong with it. I don't mind it at all. I don't, you know, the thought of getting up and having to go out and just stand there for like 4 hours and do stuff, it's not fun beforehand, but you know, once you're there, you just sort of get on with it. It's fine, and I'm not complaining about it. I don't mind it at all. There are a few things. There are a few things about it. First off, I've got, because I'm a pretty tall guy. I'm not the tallest guy, but I'm a pretty tall guy. Like, I don't know, at least compared to the sink. Basically, the sink is not very high up. And compared to how tall I am, basically, you have to lean over to get in the sink. And it's not like massive. It's not like you're like this the whole day, but it's just slight, like, you know, you're just hunching over a bit like this. And it doesn't seem like that much of a thing. But in the two, I've been working there long. I've only worked 2 days. I'm 2 Sundays now. But both days have apparently been like really, really busy. Like, it's just been non-stop dishes coming in. And like, the people there have been quite surprised, because usually like in February, it's not that busy, especially on Sundays. Usually they thought they were going to have like loads of time, like in the middle of the day to like show me how to do things and give me experience in other things. But it's weird. Usually all the business comes in like summer when the weather's nice and there's people going about, but for some reason it's just been really busy on both the days I've been there apparently, and just non-stop dishes, man. And just, so basically I've been stuck in the kitchen. I've been stuck at the sink almost the whole day, like, and you know, very rarely am I like, so every now and then when it dies down a bit, the person who does the cooking and makes stuff, they'll sometimes go in the sink and do some washing. I can go do some other stuff, like take things out to people and clear tables and stuff like that, and I can have a bit of a break. But the both days I'm in there, I've been standing at the sink, look, bent over, not bent over, that's no, let's move on, like hunched over at the sink for like ages on end, like with very few breaks. And your back starts to absolutely ache. Like, every single, like, almost, I'll clean a few dishes, and then I have to, like, stand back and go like that. Because genuinely, it doesn't sound that, and it's not that bad. Like I said, the whole job, I don't mind it. It's not the worst thing, but it's not comfortable when you're standing hunched over at a sink for most of, like, the best part of 4 hours. It really sucks, you know, because the sink isn't very high, and I'm quite tall compared to the sink, so I do have to lean over, and it sucks. It really sucks. Like I say, it's not the worst thing, but it's not fun. It's not the best when you have to constantly, every few dishes, you've got to go like that. And yeah, it's not great. It's one of the downsides. So yeah, my back really hurts afterwards. Another thing, because both days I've been there, I've basically been standing in one spot the whole time, like the same bit, just washing dishes, sticking them in the disinfecting thing, and then, you know, not much walking about. So basically, when you stand in one, it's not the same as like walking. So if you're walking all day, then it's a bit different. I mean, when you're walking, you probably get more tired, but when you're standing in one spot the whole time, and then when I'm like getting ready to go or something, you know, especially after 4 hours of pretty much just standing in the same spot and not sitting down all day. I don't think I've ever like sat down since I've been there. I don't think I've sat in any of the chairs or anything. Your legs really start to hurt. Like, you just feel like the blood is like not flowing. You got like loads of, I don't know what it is, but like, you know, your muscles really start to ache. You've got to like, you know, like bend your legs and sort of stretch them out a bit and try and get blood flowing back through them normally, because, you know, they do start to hurt when you're just sort of standing in the same spot all day. So, and then the next day your legs, you know, start, you know, you've got sore muscles and stuff like that, which, you know, it just, you know, admittedly I'm not very fit, but like a lot of people, if you're just standing in one spot like for the best part of 4 hours, then your legs do start to ache quite a bit because your blood's not flowing the same. And yeah, so that hurts as well. It's not like pain, but it's, you know, it's uncomfortable more than anything. Another thing with working at the sink, because your hands are in the water all day, like, my hands go very, very pruney. They go very wrinkly, and they're like really, like, for a few, like, you know, hours after I go home, they're still kind of pruney. They're still kind of like, they're not wet, they're still dry, but like, you know, they're very pruney and very like weird. And then, because like the water is usually hot, but every now and then I take them out and I dry, and then like sometimes I have to run cold water and everything, and then the constant transition between dry and wet and hot and cold, it's not good for your skin. Basically my skin starts to like, I don't know, get really dry afterwards, and like I have to like use this moisturizing stuff, which, you know, it's whatever, say what you will, Drew using moisturizer, yeah, fuck off. Basically, you know, and like the other night after I did it started to hurt. Like, my hands genuinely started to hurt. It was burning. after I put the stuff on, and because, like, you know, they get really dry, like around like the knuckle bit here, and it gets really dry, and genuinely when I put the stuff on, it started to burn, it started to really hurt, like it started to sting really bad. And I was like, oh, okay, that was sick. So yeah, started, you know, rub the stuff on, and then like for like 5-10 minutes after, it was just sore. I don't know why. And yeah, so it causes that was pain. That was actually pain. It was very, very uncomfortable. So yeah, that's sick. My hands are fine like now, because like it makes my knuckles very smooth, but like you can tell they're not like quite normal. Like the skin just looks like it's, you know, I don't know. You can tell that they've been in. They're different than what they usually are, because like being in water all day, like constantly transitioning between wet and cold, hot and dry, or wet, hot and cold, dry and wet, you know what I mean. Yeah, it's not good for your hands, basically, which, you know, it sounds like a bit of a pussy excuse, but especially when it starts to burn, like it stings, it's only happened once, to be fair. I shouldn't be complaining, but yeah, it kind of fucks up your hands a bit. What else is there? Hang on. What else? It got really hot one time. Basically, it was really hot the other... It was weird. It was like 40... Was it 14 degrees? I think it was like 14 degrees. That's Celsius, in case any of you are like using Fahrenheit for some reason. It was really hot the other... the last Sunday I was working. Just last week, I suppose. Yeah, it was really hot that day. I say really hot. It was very, very mild. The sun was shining. And like for a lot of you, 14 degrees is not very hot at all. But in Scotland in February, considering it's now snowing, it's like in the negatives. It's quite warm for any, you know. If it was 14 degrees all the time in Scotland, and it was just sunny, I'd be quite happy, because it's just like the perfect temperature for me. A lot of people think it's quite cold, but like in this country, we're kind of used to it being, you know, 5 degrees most of the time, which isn't like that cold, but it, you know, it's not. It's not. It's 14 degrees is very nice. Like when you get close to 20, it's like quite hot and you're sweating a lot, and it's a bit uncomfortable. But when it's like that, it's quite nice. So it was quite a mild day. But then, you know, when it's mild, it's quite nice. But when you're in it's not a very big cafe, so it's quite small. There's quite a lot of people in there. So there's a lot of body heat, a lot of, you know, carbon dioxide, whatever. It gets very hot with all the people in there, plus all the cookers and, you know, coffee machines and the hot water. Standing in one bit and having to, you're constantly like moving, like. You're not moving, but like you're constantly moving your hands, like scrubbing dishes and stuff like that. Your body temperature really starts to go up. Plus, the heating was on. Why the heating was on, I have no idea. Some boy went into the toilets, like, and said to the wifey, you know, you're the wifey, my boss, technically. You know, your heating's on. She was like, oh, it's actually. I wonder, because we were all sweating in that, especially in the kitchen, because all the cookers were on, all the stuff's cooking. It was horrific. I sound so like such a spoiled shit right now. It wasn't nice. It was very, very warm, and I was sweating quite a lot. And you know, like I say, it's not a bad job. I like it. It's very, it's, you know, it's a decent job. And you know, I'm lucky to be getting, you know, paid to, you know, do stuff to work. You know, it could be much worse. I'm not complaining, but there are a few downsides to it. And it was very hot. Once they turned the heating off, it was very nice. It was much more mild, it was much more fine. But why the heating was on, I have no idea. But yeah, so it was very hot for a while. Usually it's not, the temperature's kind of fine, but when the heating's off and it's, you know, 14 degrees outside. Yeah, once there's like a few windows in the kitchen, and like every now and then a cold breeze will come through, especially when it was that warm. Every now and then, like every like 20 minutes or something, a cool breeze will come through, hit your face, and you're just like, yes, please, more. And then you don't get anything for a while. But yeah, is that, what else do I do? That's really the only bad things about it. It's a lot of discomfort, but I guess you'll get that with any job, I guess, in theory. So yeah, like I said, I'm not complaining. There's just some of the downsides to it. Overall, I'm quite happy with it. You know, getting paid is sick. I'm gonna go sort out, I'm going to the bank to sort out some things with my bank account, so that I get like, the pay goes into somewhere different. That doesn't matter. Basically, you know, getting paid is good. Getting, you know, having a source of income is pretty good. And yeah, it's my first job, and it's alright. It's decent. The people there are quite nice. Yeah, it's a pretty decent job. I'm quite happy with it. And yeah, so at least I can say to people, I've got a job now. I don't sound like a lazy shit, but I've never worked a day in my life before. People are like, come on, dude. Everyone works at your age. Come on, everyone has part-time jobs. You know, sure. And that's just something new in my life, which has been going on. So yeah. 44 minutes. 45. Basically, 15 minutes left before we hit the hour mark. I'm not really worried about... A lot of people are, like, worried about hitting the hour mark. Podcasts are hitting a certain length of video. I don't really care. Or, like, when a podcast goes on too long, some people are worried about that it's too long. I don't really worry. I just speak for as long. Like, I don't think I'd ever be able to just speak to a camera myself for, like, 3 hours. Like, if I had a guest, then I probably could speak for hours and hours. But, like, I don't know. I'm not really worried about the time. If it's, like, you know, half an hour, 45 minutes, then it's fine. If it's, like, an hour and a half, then it's fine as well. Or even 2 hours, you know, whatever. I'm not really worried. Something I could mention. Rocket League. Oh, Rocket League. Rocket League. Rocket League's gone badly recently, so... Obviously, I made the video with Matt. We got to Shooting Star, and it was amazing. I was so happy. We after we finished recording that video, it was a bit late on in the... It wasn't really late on, but we just... Matt was like, oh, come on, we've got to keep this momentum going. We've got to play more games. We've got to shoot you. You know, we've got to get you a cushion so you're, like, super Shooting Star Division, like, 2 or 3. So you've got, like, a cushion when you go, like, go play by yourself for a while. And I'm like, I didn't really want to, just in case, but I was like, okay, fine, that makes sense. So we played a game. And we lost the first game after we made that video. After we were so happy, we were like, yes, we did it! We lost the game after that, which we didn't record. So that sucked. And I didn't get demoted, but I was still in Shooting Star Division 1. And I didn't get demoted, so then I was like, okay, we probably shouldn't play another game after that. But then Matt was like, oh, no, but now, you know, you're like one game off getting demoted, so we have to play another one just to keep, you know, that cushion, so, you know, you don't get demoted immediately after. So I'm like, okay, we kind of have to now. So we played another game. We lost again, and that was, okay, shit. So that video basically means nothing. Even if you enjoyed that video, it kind of sours it a bit to know that we went down immediately after that, or I did at least. So then he was like, okay, and then after that he was like, okay, what do you want to do now? I was like, okay, we'll do one more, and if we lose again, then just leave it. If we win again, just one more. We're only doing one more. Did we win or did we lose? I can't remember. We played that game, then we played another one, and basically I was in Rising Star Division, like, 5 by that point, which kind of sucked, so I'd gone down, but we still had the video where we got to Shooting Star, and it was amazing, and then I made that video, uploaded it, and I was in Rising Star, and then I think I didn't play Rocket League for, like, a couple days or something. It didn't feel like that long, but I didn't play for a few days for some reason. I was just doing other stuff. I think I was playing a bit of Skyrim. I was just doing other things, and then I went back to playing it, and oh gosh, it went badly. It went horribly. I've been on a losing streak in Rocket League, and I've been on a big losing streak since then. I'm now in doubles. I'm Division 1 in Rising Star. I'm probably like one or two, I'm probably one game off getting demoted to Challenger Elite, which is, that's embarrassing. That is just straight up embarrassing. And I don't know what it is. Like, I had a few, like, sessions where I played, like, a few games in a row, and every single one I wanted to smash the controller on the wall. I don't know what happened. I don't know what's happened. I don't know. I just feel like I've dropped a level since. I don't know. Okay, someone came in to my mum, was like, can I put your washing? And I'm like, no, we're recording. Go away. Basically, I've had a couple of mini sessions where I tried to, like, you know, get my form back. Okay, I'll go on now, and I'll stay chill, and I won't get angry. And if I go up division, then great. If I don't, then okay, I'll try again later. And that, but every single time I just throw the controller at the wall. I'm not very good at controlling rage in Rocket League. It's not something I'm good at, which is, you know, Rocket League's just an infuriating game sometimes. So yeah, I've been dropping divisions in every, not just doubles, like in solo duel, in 3v3s. I've just been, I don't know what's happened. I genuinely don't. I haven't played for a few more days since, and I was like, okay, I just gave myself a break. Don't play it for a while. I just couldn't go back to it. I couldn't go back to the feeling of just losing. And I'm just really, I can't go to Challenger Elite. I can't do it. Come on, like, I don't want to go back to Challenger Elite. I don't want to go back down to the challenge. I don't want to go back down to those yellow ones. Just no. I'm not doing that. So, I don't know what's happened, basically, even when I probably just need to, like, play for a few days. I need to get back into playing, like, every single day and improving that way, and I'll do a lot of losing. I might just have to jump into unranked players and just get my form back and then slowly transition myself back into it. Maybe get Matt back on and start playing with him again in doubles, because I'm not... Okay, I'm just not gonna go back into ranked doubles until I'm sure that I've got my form back, because I'm not going to challenge. I refuse to go to Challenger Elite, right? I'm never going back to that. I'm staying in the blue ones, basically. I want to stay blue. So yeah, basically, I'm not gonna play ranked doubles for a while. Basically, there's something in my life. I'm shit at Rocket League now. I don't know what's happened. Like, I haven't played for a few days, so I haven't like tested it. But it's part of the reason, it's a very small reason why I've uploaded, because I'm just bad at Rocket League now, and like, not even to the point where it's like funny in some of my other videos, just like, I just do a lot of stupid things. I just feel like I'm not as confident on the controls, which I think, again, just comes with playing the game very regularly, and just, you know, not playing for a few days, your skill will start to drop, even, you know, if you're really, you know, the pro gamers, they play every single day, and like, not that I want to become a pro Rocket League, I'd love to become pro Rocket League, but I don't think that's ever happening. You know, Max can do that. Matt can maybe get there, but you know, not me. That's never how I love Rocket League a lot, and I really want to get better at it, but I think we've all seen I'm not getting there. That's a step too far, maybe. I don't really care about becoming a pro gamer. I don't really play games for that. I'd rather be a YouTuber than a pro gamer, to be honest. I just like to play games for fun. So yeah, I'm leaving round doubles for a while. I'm gonna try and get better at it again. And I don't know, like I say, I haven't been uploading any, I haven't really wanted to record a Rocket League video, just because it's just really, I don't enjoy playing the game, because I just feel like I can't do the things I would usually do. It's weird. So I'll try and get back into that, start recording videos on that again. And yeah, I was going to say something else. What was that? I don't know. I feel like we might be coming to the crescendo, because I just realized I haven't done a podcast in ages, and usually it takes me like even if I didn't do a podcast for like, you know, a few weeks before, it would take me a while to get back into it. But like, now I haven't done one in months and months and months, and I've just sort of thrown myself in at the deep end, and like, I don't know, I feel like I've done quite well, to be fair. I feel like I haven't thought about it too much, so I've done quite well. But I don't know, I'm starting to get a bit lightheaded. I feel like I've talked a lot. I'm starting to ache in my scent core. I think it's kind of weird. I think I've been sitting straight for too long. I need to just sort of sit back and chill for a minute. Okay, so, I've covered a few things. So what have I covered? Why haven't been on YouTube? I'm shy at Rocket League again. My first job. And I covered something else. And the crazy growth that I've had recently. So, I've got some other things, but not really things that I feel like I really want to get super into. So, I could keep going, but you know what, for the first podcast back, I think I'm just going to call it there. I'll probably end up, don't click off yet, because I'll probably end up ranting for about 5-10 minutes at the end of this anyway. So, yeah, so I've covered a few things. Usually I'd sort of go over them again, like not go over them, but like sort of recap what I've done, like say the main topics and then, I don't know, add things, but I don't know. I feel like I've covered everything. Hopefully videos will be coming back, you know. Like I said, two or three videos a week. That's ultimately my aim for like this year, basically. Admittedly, we're close to March now, which doesn't bode well, does it? But you know, that's basically my aim. Hopefully gonna get into doing more podcasts, that's the word we're looking for. Getting guests on, all of Team Apollo, maybe Matt, and I don't know, other people, Unflushable maybe, I don't know. And yeah, other more videos. I don't know. I feel like maybe I need to do some other different video. I want to do more of those edited gaming videos, like Rocket League and Skyrim and I don't know, Black Ops 3, whatever. I probably need new games, to be honest, another game to play. But I don't know, I want to do, like, that's something I thought about at the start of this year. I want to do some other videos, like not necessarily vlogs, but like the Shit Happens video, just being a bit more creative and doing some different kinds of videos. Like I said, I just feel like I don't have time. I feel like I need to get some more, just, you know, consistency with my normal videos. So I don't know, if you've got any ideas on that sort of thing, videos you'd like to see me do, that sort of thing. It's a very cliche thing that YouTubers ask, but if you know, and a lot of the time you don't get that many good responses, to be honest. A lot of the time it's, oh, do this game, or do this game that I can't afford, or do this kind of vlog, which I can't do because I don't have this camera, you know, whatever. But if you have any opinions, any ideas, anything, please leave them in the comments. I'm always open to anything you guys got to say. And yeah, I love reading comments. So, thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have enjoyed the podcast, then I don't know, let me know. I don't know if how you've watched this. Hopefully you've enjoyed listening to it, doing whatever you're doing, playing Rocket League. I don't know. Not wanking. No, you wouldn't be wanking. That'd be weird listening to me while you're... Yeah, no one's done that. Anyway, why did I think of that? I don't know. Let's just let's pretend that never happened. So, fuck's sake. Right. Oh, on with the outro. Thank you very, very, very much for watching, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed this. If you have enjoyed and you want to see more podcasts, then definitely let me know. And hopefully we'll get some more videos out. Basically, just more videos. I just want to make videos. We're gonna make some videos once I get my assignment done today, which isn't looking good. But you know what? Maybe I can churn something out for tomorrow. I don't know. Maybe we'll get another snow day tomorrow, and I can get away with it till the weekend. Because today's Thursday, and tomorrow's Friday. If we can get a snow day on Friday, that gives me the whole weekend to procrastinate. Ultimately, I'll probably end up procrastinating and then leaving it Sunday night again. But and I've got English. I've got a portfolio for English, and I've got like two essays to like do some redrafting on, and I've got physics assignments that I've got to be thinking about, and I've got history as well. Assignments, because we've done the prelims. The prelims were something I was going to talk about. In the prelims are basically like I think it's mock exams you call it in England or something. Basically, like the practice exams you do in like January, sort of, and then you do the real ones in May. We've just done them, and I don't know. Some of them have been like okay, and some of them have not been so okay. But after we've done the prelims, now it's just basically revision, consolidating what we know, getting prepared for the exams in May, and doing like the added value stuff or the assignments that you do in class, and getting you know the extra marks for them. So you do well to get good marks in them, because they add to your final mark. So if you can get a good mark in your assignment or your folio or whatever, then it basically gives you a cushion. It basically boosts you up, can boost you up from a C to a B in the final exam, or a B to an A if you do well. So it's something that you should really do well, which I'm questionable for, especially for RMPS. But you know what? I'm gonna probably do that now once I get all this, get the thing ready to upload. Like I said, I've ranted for about 10 minutes or whatever. So thank you for watching, everyone. That's just, like I say, some things on my life. I've talked about some things, experiences, things going on in my life. Leave whatever thoughts or opinions you have in the comments. Just leave a novel in the comments. I love reading novels. I like leaving... Oh, gosh, that's bad. Didn't mean to do that. Poor old pop filter. Yeah, I love writing comments in comment sections and reading comments from you. So anything you're thinking about, leave in the comments, whatever it is. And, thank you very, very, very much for watching, everyone. I hope to see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye for now. Okay. Podcasts are exhausting, man. I just need to sit back here and just... I don't know. Just sit back and relax now. Even though I've got loads of work to do, and I've got videos that I should make, but... See? I just want to be lazy again. I just want to be lazy, but I'm not going to be. I'm actually going to do stuff. I am actually. So, yeah. He says this. Okay.